For more on all this, let's bring in Wyoming Senator John Barrasso, chair of the Senate Republican Conference. Good to see you, Senator. Thanks for being here. You know, it's not only the Trump folks who are criticizing what she said, this, you know, the same values. Even NBC's Yamiche Alcindor. Now, she's about as far to the left as NBC can get, and that's pretty far left. But she put out a tweet saying, or an X post saying, VP Harris keeps saying my values haven't changed while not explaining why her positions have changed. I mean, that's really the question. What motivates this woman and how will she govern? The American people have a right to know, don't they?
The American people do have a right to know, David. You're absolutely like, by any definition, it was a softball interview with CNN. They just pitched little marshmallows to her. But it's no surprise that Kamala Harris wants to flip-flop on these dangerous positions that she's taken because they are losing positions. Like, she wasn't prepared for that interview, and she's really not qualified to be president of the United States. If she can't go and stand up against CNN, I mean, how is she going to be going toe-to-toe with China or the Kremlin? So she keeps saying, my values have not changed. And I believe they haven't. Those are the values, the dangerous values of a San Francisco liberal, the values that got us these high prices, the open border. You know, at the convention, you know, she said, we're not going back. People want to go back to the low prices, the secure border, the safe communities that we had when Donald Trump was president. And that's why I'm doing everything I can to make sure that Donald Trump gets reelected. We get a Republican House, a Republican Senate to get the country back on track.
Well, you know, she's going so far, not just repeating the same line, my values haven't changed, but she's actually making up things about what she said in the past. She said during the interview last night that she actually said in the debate that she was not against fracking or she was not in favor of fracking. But here's, we went into the debate that she had with Vice President Pence, and she said no such thing. And of course, in 2019, she was very specific about saying she banned fracking. Here's the soundbite.
There's no question I'm in favor of banning fracking. So, yeah.
No question. I mean, no question. It's that simple.
Well, that's just one of a number of things. One is that she wants to ban fracking, and that's going to drive up energy costs for all Americans. When she was running back then, she said she wanted to eliminate private health insurance for Americans, but she wants to give free health care to illegal immigrants. She went and actually worked to bail out criminals in the United States, but makes it easier for illegal immigrant criminals to stay here. So she's had all these policies, and it's cumulative damage that she's done to this country. Prices up 20%, 10 million illegal immigrants into this country, including members of criminal cartels, drug dealers, people on the terrorist watch list. That's why we need to get Donald Trump and J.D. Vance into the White House and a full Republican Senate and House to help them get the country together back on track.
Here's J.D. Vance was on Fox this morning, and here's his take on what he saw last night with her interview. Roll that.
I felt a little bad for her because it was clear that she wasn't totally sure-footed and she didn't totally know why she was saying the things that she was saying. She's been coached to pretend to be a moderate. Unfortunately, guys, she's governed as a San Francisco liberal, and because of it, Americans are poorer, the world is more chaotic, and our border is wide open.
I mean, specifically on fracking, clearly the reason that she's willing to actually distort what she said or make up stuff that she said in the 2020 debate is because she wants Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania does very well with fracking. The people like fracking. Even the Democratic senator likes fracking. But the point is her past has been definitively against fracking. I mean, it's just clearly a political move, right?
Yeah, these are all political moves by her, and she has been, as J.D. just said, coached to say certain things and certain buzzwords like laser-focused and on day one. David, her day one came almost 4 years ago, and that day she was laser-focused on opening the border for 10 million illegal immigrants with free housing, free health care, free credit cards. She was laser focused on attacking American energy like fracking. And that's what this Biden administration has been doing, attacking American energy and our workers. That's why the gasoline prices doubled. That's why food prices went up so high. So I'm a lot less interested in what she said the last 40 days as I am the damage that she's done to this country over the last nearly 4 years, and she wants a promotion. She needs to be fired.
Well, as far left as Biden himself has governed, and of course she was at his side, but he clearly has been pushing things, and maybe somebody was pushing him to push things that veered this country to the left. But it could go even further, and specifically in dealing with the law, her legal, if she becomes president, her judicial appointments or nominations could really reflect the far left views that she comes from. Her brain trust, after all, is in Berkeley. And one of those guys, by the way, is the dean of the University of California Berkeley Law School, a guy named Irwin Shermaniski, who actually, he doesn't want to just amend the Constitution to get a couple of tweaks in. He wants to replace it completely. He was on MSNBC earlier today to talk about it. I want to play that and get your reaction. Roll it.
Sure. Rather than a series of constitutional amendments, isn't it time to start thinking of a new Constitution? Isn't it absurd that we're governed in 2024 by a Constitution written in 1787 for a small, agrarian, slave-owning society?
Now, one has to think that the dean of the University of California in Berkeley, where she hailed from, is going to be top on her list of judicial appointments, maybe even a Supreme Court appointment. We may have a justice of the Supreme Court who wants to tear up the Constitution and replace it.
Well, she's not going to get that even if she is president. I'm going to do everything I can to make sure she does not become president. But I'm also going to make sure we have a Republican Senate so that somebody like that who's been nominated by a President Harris, which I hope never happens, that we will block that nomination, that confirmation from ever coming into place. But what do you expect from the wackos in Berkeley? We in Wyoming call it berserkly. I want to tell you what very few people do in Congress and very few lawyers do. The 90 days running up to an election, I get the Federalist Papers, and I read one a day, and there's 85 of them, and slowly three or four pages. This is the basis for which the Constitution was written. I think that the more Americans understood the basis of our Constitution, how much we would respect and admire what those founding fathers were able to come up with. We have an incredible system of government. I'm going to stand by it, defend the Constitution. That's what the Republican Party is going to continue to do, and that's what we're going to continue to do if we're able to take the White House, the House, and the Senate.
But you know, Senator, I don't mean to be the bearer of bad news, but the dean of the University of California Berkeley Law School has a lot of sway in the legal sphere. I mean, think of the thousands of students in whose minds he's put these ideas about tearing up the Constitution because it was created by slave owners.
Well, you know, Justice Scalia in his writing said, the real problem is that there are not enough law students and law schools that teach related to the Federalist Papers, who people don't understand the Constitution. And to your point, we've had judges nominated by the Biden-Harris team who have come to hearings in the United States Senate for confirmation and really didn't know the basics of the Constitution of the United States.
I've seen John Kennedy go after those people, yes.
Very effectively. Yeah. We need to get the country back on track, and that involves a Republican House, a Republican Senate, and a Republican White House in 2025.
Yeah, I tell you, it's a critical moment when you think of the judicial appointments that could come out of the Harris administration if she ever becomes president. It would be frightening what might happen. Senator Barrasso, thank you very much. Good to see you. Appreciate it.